పర్లేదు, మంచి ఎడ్యుకేషన్ బాగుంది, అక్కడే మార్చేస్తామా అని ఆలోచిస్తున్నాను. ఇదే ఇది ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ డీటెయిల్స్, వెనక స్టూడెంట్ డీటెయిల్స్, ఫీ డీటెయిల్స్ అన్ని చేసేసి అంటే ఫీజ్ డీటెయిల్స్. ఇది ఫీజ్ ఫస్ట్ టర్మ్ 67,630, సెకండ్ టర్మ్ వచ్చి 65,130. బై ఫస్ట్ ఏప్రిల్ ఇది పే చేసి ఉండాలి, ఫస్ట్ సెప్టెంబర్. కానీ వాళ్ళు ఏం చేస్తారంటే ఎవ్రీ ఇయర్ మార్చ్ ఎండ్ లోపల వీ హ్యావ్ టు పే, రెండు చెక్ ఇచ్చేవాళ్ళ, లేదంటే ఇది ఎగ్జామ్ అంటే అలౌ చేయరు వాళ్ళు. బుక్స్ అంతా ఇప్పుడు ఇవ్వలేదు తనకి.
But have you realized something, Aishwarya? Not actually, the last year due to COVID, the government asked the schools to collect only tuition fees, and this year they have told, the government has passed an order to collect only 70% of last year's fees and refund 30%. But our school, the school in which my daughter studies, they have clearly told that they cannot refund the fee, and it is Euro school. They have clearly told that they cannot refund the fee. You have to pay the full fees. And moreover, they have increased the fees to another 15,000. Like last year, it was 1,18,000. This year, we have to pay 1,36,000. Like it is almost 20,000 more. And when we called the school regarding this, and we asked, see, we have the government order, we have the copy, everything. They told we cannot refund the 30%. And moreover, if you want any installment also, we can give you only two installments. We told like give five installments, like so that it will be easy for us to pay the fees. No, they told. And moreover, they from last year, even though it was COVID affected year last year, they have showed us to a loan, like in the school app itself, there is a loan option where we have to pay an interest, which is far worse than paying the fee, because the amount will be another 20,000 more. Like already we feel the school fees is higher. Every year they are rising 20,000 higher. And this year it is too much. Like we have to opt for the loan and we have to pay the interest, which is far worse. Like we are very anxious. We are very anxious.
So your only option is loan is what they're telling. Take the loan and pay the fee.
Yes. If you don't take the loan or pay the fee, just leave the school. That's it. Like we have to leave the school.
So Shyam, time and again we have been seeing a spate of recent incidents where parents for the last 1 year, they've only been rallying saying that, you know, they have issues with the school fees. We saw Karnataka government stepping in, then saying 70% of the tuition fee, if you have taken 100%, refunded. Parents have not been refunded. Now this year we see they're saying they're collecting 100%.
Right.
Indirectly, that is you have no way out.
Right.
Right? You have to pay it through your online, the website. The other option you see is your loan with interest. So that's an explicit manner. So can you tell me the exact, you know, the sequence of events?
So since government has already mandated 30%, we should be getting a refund if we already paid it. And if those who are not able to pay, then school is forcing them to pay it even by this gray quest financial institution. And then specifically there we need to provide our child's name and then enrollment number. That is nowhere valid. And if we don't use that, then we don't have any option. Then they will not be.
So what is the way that you have to pay the fees? Is website the only way?
Yeah, the website is the only way.
And where it automatically takes you to loan.
Yeah, it gives you option whether you have to pay through your NEFT and all those details. Otherwise, you go with the loan. There is no other way.
So how difficult is this? Now we are, as it is, we understand the fees itself is too much. Then you're looking at a loan with interest. How difficult is this on the parents?
So this is nowhere according to the government rules. If they follow, then we don't need to worry about paying extra. We don't need to pay that. The last whole year, we only half of the syllabus got completed. 4 hours of the class happening. No facility we have got from the school. But still we have to pay everything. That is not at all acceptable and not bearable also for the every parent.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. So, can you tell us about What really is the situation now? Last year we see that the government had passed this particular order which came earlier this year saying for the last academic year 70% of the tuition fee, but that is not really the case, ground reality. Now the school goes on to tell the parents explicitly if you're unable to pay the fees, take loan and pay.
Yeah.
What is your situation about?
Yeah, even in our school is Presidency School, and Presidency School has come up with, they have tied up with a financial company called Judo, and they're asking us to take up loan from Judo and then pay the fee. They do say it's an interest-free loan, but most of the parents wouldn't be willing to share their personal details with them. And one saddening thing is the school has already shared our personal details with Judo, and Judo is trying to call us on our numbers, which we are not happy because the parents' details should be confidential at all times. And school has also asked us to pay the fees within next 5 days, otherwise our online classes will be blocked and so and so. They have also increased the fees for this year, the last year, wherein the government says this, the fee should not be increased, but whereas our school has merged both the annual fee and tuition fee, and they're saying it has a school fee, which seems to be like around 27.5% hike, wherein government has clearly told that there must not be any hike for the last academic year, but school are not willing to do anything in favor of parents. They're not ready to help any parents.
How about the government? Is the government doing anything about it?
No, even government is not doing anything. The government has only passed the order, and that order doesn't stand anywhere. Whenever we go and approach the school says the school is taking up the High Court's interim order, where the interim order says that you have to look into parents' cases case by case. So our school is asking us to show us the last 3 years' IT returns as well as our monthly income. They're asking us
school
to furnish all this. Yes, they're asking us to furnish all these details if we have to avail that 30% discount. But government order, nowhere it says that the parent have to furnish their financial details. But yeah,
okay,
this
name?
Is the current situation. My name is Megha, and I'm from Presidency School.
Okay.